Welcome to EPG Patashala. Today we are going to discuss the public policies, its origin, and first and second models we are going to discuss today. The concept, nature, scope of public policy, and evolution of public policy. Public policy is as old as the political systems, as old as the governments. Wherever and whenever governments have existed, public policy was a part of the political system, public policy was a part of the governments. Whether it is oligarchy, monarchy, aristocracy, democracy, whatever may be the form of the government, public policy was formulated and implemented by various governments. Whether it is ancient period, modern period, or medieval period, whatever it is, public policy, the content of public policy was part and parcel of all the political system, all the governing political systems all over the world. It may not be called as a public policy, but content was there as a part and parcel of the political systems. You take the example of Kautilya. In his Arthashastra, he was advocating the king and what type of the reforms and what type of the governance should be there in the political system. You take the example of Machiavelli. Machiavelli also was advocating various reforms. You take the example of Aristotle. Aristotle was advocating that uneven development will create problems and equal development is necessary for any political system so that the political system will be successful one. You take the example of Jeremy Bentham. Jeremy Bentham was advocating jail reforms. Greatest happiness of the greatest number. So public policy was a part and parcel of all the political systems, whatever may be the period and whatever may be the form of the government, but it is only in recent times it is being called as a public policy. Otherwise, the content was there, all the political systems used to formulate the public policies and implemented by them, but the term public policy is being given in recent days. It is being discussed in various universities in the form of public policies.
Introduction. Running a state requires a well-laid direction and a course of action, which is a minimum expectation from a policy. In its origin, policy was not seen separate from the issue of governance. It was only after the Second World War that some focus was being given to it. Both the political scientists and the public administrators wanted to inquire the basis of success or the failure of various programs and plans of government. In search for this, they saw public policy as an opportunity to realize their assessment for the same. At the same time, the Western countries wanted to increase their influence on the newly emerging developing world for the revival of badly hit economies due to mega war. Therefore, a group of American scholars led by Harold Laswell and others started promoting the discipline of policy sciences. The success or failure of a government to a large extent is dependent upon the outcome of public policies. Concept, nature, and scope of public policy. As a common person, the term policy has always been seen with a particular motive and focus of the government, be it education, health, energy, and the like. But one thing which is to be highlighted is its link with public, that is, people at large. Since its inception, the study of policy has been dominated by political science, focusing on the values that were to be transformed into programs and actions of the governments of the day. It was only in the 1960s that both as discipline and practice, the disciplines of public administration and management made it as one the core areas of research. Earlier, the decision makers used to focus on the success or failure of a policy based on its impact on a section for which it was meant. Later, it was found out that both inter and intra-governmental mechanisms are also equally important, especially when we are dealing with public policy. Therefore, it was agreed to have an interdisciplinary approach with multidisciplinary focus for public policy. In order to understand the term public policy, we must be clear about what we mean by the adjective public. In social sciences, it is extremely difficult to relate and define public due to its vastness and contextualization difficulties. The word public denotes a variety of meanings. It originates from the Latin word publico. It is related to English word populus. In general, public denotes some mass population, the people. Here it means governmental. Public policy therefore simply means governmental policy formulated in a political setting. Public policies are matter of common interest. They are related with civic or public affairs or affairs of office or state. One way of defining public is to make a differentiation between public and private spheres respectively. The realm of public became a necessity when smaller associations with limited role were deemed to be private and coordinate with their acts and bring order. Rainey in the year 1997 argues that the distinction between public and private can be made with reference to organizations. Public-private dichotomy involves three factors. Interests affected, whether benefits or losses, are communal or restricted to individuals. Access to facilities, resources, information, and agency, whether a person or organization acts for an individual or for the community as a whole. The major task of public policies is to give expression to this public or general interest. The concepts of policy and public policy. Just like public, the idea of policy is difficult to conceptualize. It could be goals, objectives, targets, course of action, and social values. Hugwid and Gunn have specified 10 uses of the term public policy. A label for the field of activity, an expression of desired state of affairs, specific proposals, decisions of the government, formal authorization, a program, output, outcome, a theory or a model, and a process. Generally speaking, the term policy has been more confined to direction and course of action that includes guidelines and conduct. Iyer was of the view that there is distinctiveness in public policy whenever focus is on the state, then it is considered having its own unique character. The policy as such would have a vast scope and far-reaching impact. There are multiple actors and consideration with lots of external influences. Therefore, Thomas Dye was correct in his assessment. Whatever government chooses to or not to do is public policy. It can be stated that policy is a premeditated action in pursuit of activities defined by those who have the power and authority. It has certain commonalities, a set of decisions, prescribed procedures and approval levels, suitability, rationality, organizational and personal politics form a general perspective. It has been described as the process of deciding who gets what, when and where and how. Gaston identifies four factors which calls for public policy: scope, number of people related with it, intensity, the extent to which people are affected by it, duration, the length of time in an issue, problem or challenge has affected people, and resources, the set of conditions necessary to make it a public issue. Policy scientists like Jenkins, Rose and Anderson our views that public policy is best conceived in terms of a process. This is because, according to Gilliatt, policy decisions are not something confined to one level of organization at the top or at one stage at the outset, but rather something fluid and ever-changing. Policy refers to a proposed course of action of an individual, a group, an institution, or a government to realize specific objectives within a given environment. Public policies are formulated and implemented by the governmental bodies and officials. They are as old as government. They are formulated and implemented to deal with diverse demands and problems of the people. That is why Paul Appleby regards policy making as the essence of public administration. There is a close relationship between politics and policy. Policy making process is a part of politics and political action. Political considerations and decisions led to emergence of policies. Policies have extensive influence on the minds of people. Therefore, policy making and implementation determine the fate of government, particularly in democratic countries. Public policy is the result of concerted and collective actions of government over a period of time. Its formulation and implementation entails a well-planned course of activities and a close collaboration between various governmental agencies. Nature of public policy. Whenever we need to discuss nature of a concept or a term, there has to be focus on the attitudes or constituents of it. A large number of related aspects have to be considered while dealing with the nature of public policy, since it is inclusive of public-private debate, plan, program, project, policy analysis, policy advocacy, and decision. Therefore, we have to understand each one of them. Public policy is crucial for the development process of a country and is basically a collective action for the fulfillment of needs and aspirations of the people at large. Public policy is a goal-oriented and result-oriented statement. It involves spelling out of a strategy and purposive action to attain the objective of government with the ultimate aim of promotion of public interest. Public policy has futuristic orientation. It is directed towards the future, which may be immediate or long-term. Public policy has the sanction of law and authority. Beyond it, its legally coercive quality is accepted as lawful. This quality of public policy makes it distinct from the policy of a private organization. Public policy is dynamic in a sense that it is continuously formulated and reformulated in response to the requirements of the environment and time. Public policy may be general or specific, broad or narrow, simple or complex, precise or implied, discretionary or exhaustive, and qualitative or quantitative. Public policy may be positive or negative. Positively, it depicts the concern of government and involves the obvious governmental action to deal with a particular issue. Negatively, it involves a decision by governmental officials regarding not taking action on a particular issue. Public policy can take diverse forms like law, ordinances, court decisions, executive orders, administrative rules, and regulations by governments. Public policies are of various types. They may be deliberate, appeal, implied, externally imposed, value-laden, value-free, macro, micro, substantive, regulatory, distributive, and redistributive policies. Policy analysis and public policy. Policy analysis can be defined as the systematic investigation of alternative policies, options, and the assembly and integration of the evidence for and against each option. It involves, according to Wickles, a problem-solving approach, the collection and interpretation of information, and some attempts to predict the consequences of alternative course of action. According to Dror, policy analysis deals with the substantive examination of policy issues and identification of preferable alternatives, in part with the help of systematic approach and explicit methods. We can say that it is the beginning of public policy where the issues, challenges and problems are to be earmarked with the possible course of action and their probable consequences. Planning and public policy. Planning involves structural and design architecture to start out social problems by facilitating public involvement and monitoring the course of various policy decisions. It is planning which deals with the issue of objectives and goals, the guidelines for the fulfillment and mechanisms to do it successfully. Unless and until a blueprint is available, a policy cannot be implemented. Policy advocacy and public policy. Policy advocacy is any effort to influence public policy by providing information, speaking to decision makers, demonstrating benefits for policy change and other such activities that encourages the adoption of the desired policy change. For communities desiring to improve health, the focus of policy advocacy will be on public policies and environmental changes that influence the health of the community. Working for change at the policy level has the potential to move directly affect the chronic disease risks of many individuals, simultaneously providing a greater health benefit to the community. Decision making and public policy. Simply speaking, decision making is informed by choice. This is independent on three main factors, namely the information made available, the understanding limits of the decision making body, and the finite amount of time available to make the decisions. The prioritization of information is an important consideration in information processing because it is assumed the way information is prioritized by organizations, it impacts the agenda setting state of public policy in significant ways. The dynamics of organization will either aid or hinder quality information from making its way to the agenda setting stage of public policy formation. Hence, with the help of information processing, sound and effective public policy can be possible. The setting out by government of a coherent overview approach to a key area or sector of society. A set of initiatives or interventions aimed at bringing about specific goals. One of initiatives in the normal course of events, continuing political debates, operational issues, requiring political judgment. And what does the government think about? That is the nature of government, that ministers are expected to offer views and opinions on almost anything happening in daily life. Scope of public policy. It is necessary to understand the categories of public policy in order to have a proper understanding of public policy. A comprehensive understanding of the concept, according to Anderson, therefore covers such areas among others as policy demands, policy decisions, policy statements, policy outputs, and policy outcomes. Policy demands. Policy demands are demands or claims made upon public officials by other actors, private or official. in a political system for action or inaction on some perceived problems, such demands may take the form of insistence that government ought to do something to a proposal for specific action on the matter. Policy decisions are decision made by public officials that authorize or give direction and content to public policy action. Examples are decisions to enact statutes, issue executive order or edicts, promulgates decree, etc. Policy statements according to Anderson are the formal expressions or articulations of public policy. They include legislative statutes, decrees, presidential orders, administrative rules, and court opinions, as well as indicating the intentions and goals of government and how to realize them. It is important to mention that policy statements are sometimes ambiguous and conflicting. They are sometimes conflicting in the sense that different and contradictory policy statements may be issued by different levels, branches or units of government. Policy outputs according to Anderson are tangible manifestation of policies and is the thing actually done in pursuance of policy decisions and statements. They are therefore what government does as distinguished from what it says it will do in response to the demands and claims made. Governmental officials take policy decision which helps to provide direction and content to policy actions. These actions produce effects on environment which are regarded as policy outputs. David Easton regards that outputs are said to constitute a body or specific instruments for the number of political system to support it, either by threats or sanctions, rewards for support given, or by socialization into political norms of the society. Examples are health centers actually built, roads constructed, schools built, industries built, etc. It is worth to note that policy outputs may sometimes differ from what policy statements indicate they should be. Policy outcomes refers to the real results produced. They indicate the actual impact on target group. Policy outcomes are the consequences, intended or unintended, for society that results from action or inaction by government. For example, the intended consequences of the current privatization policy being implemented in India are efficiency and high profit of the privatized firms, removal of government subsidies of public enterprises, thereby saving crore of rupees worth of public fund spent on them over the years, etc. But the unintended consequences are inflation and the consequent hardship for families due to low purchasing power of people. Again, the capitalization of policy and the policy of merging of banks being currently implemented by the Reserve Bank of India may achieve the intended consequence of strengthening the banks, thereby securing public funds, but it may lead to retrenchment of the workers of the bank.
Public policies are political activity of any government. Public policy is a part of political system. They are dynamic, they are very important for any political system. They are key factor for any success of any political system. For any government, especially in democratic political setup, policy formulation, policy implementation is a very, very important aspect. The success of governments depends on the policy formulation and policy implementation. So public policy is an important act of any political system, any government. So public policy is an important aspect for all the governments in all over the world.